Welcome from Budapest. We have here two smartphones, the Huawei S and P8 Lite and the P8, both beautiful devices, but we have on the left the double the price device with $500 starting, and then we have here the M249 device, which have both a 30 megapixel camera in the back. You can see we have your dual flash and your single flash. This is completely made out of plastic all around, and on the back here it's completely metal or unibody design, which makes it of course a lot more expensive. Otherwise on the bottom we have dual speakers on both, micro USB of course for charging, which is quite important, and we have on the right side a 5-inch display, on the left side a 5.2-inch display, but here we have only a 1280x720 pixel resolution, which is HD, and on the left we have the full HD resolution, which is also quite nice, but of course a lot more in power there is needed. We have 2680 milliamps on the left as battery. Here we have 2200 milliamps, so a little bit less. Even though they are the same thickness, you could even say that the P8 Lite is a little bit thicker, but if you just connect the more compatible ports, you can see that the design is really identical, with the power button in the middle, volume rocker, and micro SIM and micro SD card slot. And on the top we have the microphone and the headset port, of course, for both devices. So again, not much of a difference there. We will compare the camera in just a second. You can see speed-wise it's kind of the same, with 3 GB RAM here, 2 GB just here. But here we have the 930 Kirin processor, and here we have the 620 Kirin processor inside by Huawei. So let's try both here the cameras. You can see here that it's looking quite nice. On the left it looks a little bit better in terms of sharpness, but the wide angle on the right one seems to be a little bit better, and in terms of speed it's also all right. Let's compare the back camera, where you can see that on the left the color seems to be nicer, but maybe that's just a display. We have to really compare the pictures that we shot after when we copied that to the computer. But otherwise it really looks on both quite nice. The speed is a little bit nicer when we just move the camera around, but otherwise you can't really feel much of a difference. I would definitely stick with the P8 Lite, because you can just buy a new one after 1 year and you don't lose that much money here. Probably the price will drop from 500 to 400 to 350 pretty quickly, and then you lost quite a bit of money compared to just buying half the price device with similar speed. But if you want to game and have a really good camera, you definitely need this one. Otherwise the P8 Lite should be definitely enough. So thank you much for tuning in. My name is Balázs from Budapest, here with the P8 and the P8 Lite by Huawei. Thank you much for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, and thank you much for watching.